I am so interested in Chai One and this open source model compared to others. When we're thinking of AlphaFold, when you're thinking of evolutionary scales model, you say it's better. How, on what measurements?
Well, first of all, thanks so much for having me here. We're really excited to be putting out this model for the community. You're asking a great question. And you know, one of the properties about this field right now, it's actually almost challenging to evaluate these models and how they compare to one another. A lot of these models are available only under non-commercial settings, which means it's hard for a company like us to actually benchmark against them. But we find on one of the benchmarks, for example, a benchmark called Posebusters, we found our model's about 77% versus a 76% from AlphaFold 3. The models are really neck and neck, and we're really excited to put out a model and make it available for everyone, including for companies that want to engage in drug discovery.
Josh, AlphaFold has the juggernaut of Google, Alphabet, behind it. Behind you sit some empty chairs, and we understand just a team of 10. What will that 30 million go towards? Is it about the talent? Is it about the compute? Where do you want to build?
Well, we're going into really exciting times. Drug discovery is an extremely hard process. The fact that drug discovery works at all with the tools that are available today is nothing short of miraculous. So we're really excited to kind of participate in this market and build tools that we hope will really make a difference in the process. I think the results speak for themselves. This is why we were excited, even just a couple of months of work, to put that out for the community, for folks to evaluate themselves and to hopefully find it useful. But there's so much work ahead of us. And I'm really just grateful for the incredible team we have behind us. My co-founders, for example, Matt McCarlson and Jack Den and Jacques Batra, among others. It's just such a great team to be working with. And I think we're just inspired by the possibilities that are ahead of us.
There's been a lot of hope and enthusiasm for the impact that AI will have on drug discovery for a while, but you are showing improvement to success rates. When does that sort of manifest itself in the real world, pushes forward the field that one day a consumer or a patient gets access to this work?
We're in the really early innings of AI and drug discovery. We're seeing those first signs of life. In Chai-1, for example, we've shown that you can integrate certain constraints into the model, the kinds of things that you might derive from wet lab experiments, and use those in order to get significantly better improvements on understanding how molecules interact with one another. Those molecules are the basis of life as we know it. So we think with these kinds of new capabilities, we can use them to better understand how molecules interact and then use that understanding to reprogram them and then hopefully come up with better medicines and just increase, make humanity better for all of us.